discussed, we have seen about the receivable management. Before that, we discussed about the cash management. All are the part of our working capital management. In at BCom level, we have discussed, we have learned about the working capital, how to project the working capital. Working capital is nothing but calculation of value of current assets and current liability. So if current assets is equal to gross working capital, then current assets less current liability is equal to net working capital, gross equal to working capital. Working capital is that form of capital which is not fixed in nature, that means a circulating capital. But the most common meaning of the working capital is difference between the two value of current assets and current liability. Now why I am discussing about the working capital? Very important part in financial management. Company has invested adequate amount in long-term sources, but if they fail to provide a good amount, optimum amount of working capital, the project will not be in successful. If you are not going to pay the payment of creditors in due time, if you fail to pay the workers' remuneration, if you fail to pay the taxes, government taxes, license fees, if you fail to pay the overheads, then definitely your operation will not be smooth in nature. You will have to face a lot of problems, difficulties. So, working capital should be adequate. It should not be more, should not be less. Thing is that there is an opposite relation between liquidity and profitability. If you are providing a maximum amount in working capital, it will increase your liquidity, but it will decrease your profitability. In vice versa case, if your less amount is provided for the working capital, it will increase your profitability, but it will decrease your liquidity and you may not be solvent to discharge your expenses time to time. And the suppliers or any other party of whom you have failed to pay the payment, that means if you are defaulting in their case, then they will take the legal action. You have to pay the amount as well as fine and then legal expenses also. So for any successful business, it is not good. It will reduce your impression in the market. It will reduce the goodwill of the company. So therefore, adequate working capital is necessary. Now we have discussed the cash management, how to maintain the cash adequate and the cash adequate level. We discussed about the cash management tool. We discussed in the cash management topic. Then regarding the receivable management, how the credit is to be extended to the customers, what are the cost attached to the credit sales, what precautions we have to take before extension of the credit to our customers. If the new customers are there, what points we have to consider before granting the credit, that is the collateral, their credit worthiness, we have to maybe cut the due diligence, or a lot of things are there. Now, our next point is inventory. Student, you may have learned about the inventory management at the FRSPL level in the accountancy. Inventory is plays an important role in working capital of the business organization. Now, first of all, what is the meaning of inventory? Inventory is also known as stock. So, inventory may be a raw material, working progress, finished goods, or maybe the other part, that is the loose goods, that is also or consumables, that is also known as what? The inventory. So for example, company is a tire industry, so rubber, or we can synthetic rubber or carbon black or maybe other ingredients, these are known as what? Raw material. If partial work is completed, finishing work or other, say 20% or 30% process is still incomplete, that is called the work in progress material. The goods which is ready for or in a saleable form, that is called the finished goods. Now other, say for example, oil is there, some other consumables are there, these are called what? The that is the consumable stock. And maybe loose goods also there, they all comes under the inventory. Now, why inventory management is necessary? Students, inventory, besides its cost, there are other two costs attached with inventory: carrying cost and order cost. If you purchase inventory in bulk, what will happen? It will reduce your order cost because you have to place less order. So it will save your transportation cost, your insurance cost on transportation, loading and unloading expenses. They all will, you can save that cost. But it will increase the other cost, means your carrying cost. Carrying cost means what? You have to block lot of amount in inventory. You have to pay the godown rate, the security expenses. So these other expenses are there. These are maybe there is a chances of pillage, or maybe a stock obsolescence, or some goods may be damaged. So these all things we have to keep in mind. If we are going to increase the carry, if we place more and more order, it will increase our order cost, reduce our carry cost, vice versa. If we place less orders, then our order cost will get reduced, but our carrying cost will get increased. Further, lot of amount should not be blocked on inventory. If we invest lot of amount in inventory, it is harmful. It will reduce our profitability. Because each and every money is important, each and every rupee is important in the business organization, and they should use it very wisely. Otherwise, the competitors will overcome our company, and our company may not be in the good profitability, and definitely they will suffer loss in long term, in a long term or in future. Now, what are the features of inventory management? Inventory normally forms major part in the working capital. So if you analyze the working capital structure, maximum part or the current assets, maximum part is occupied by the inventory. So the company has to make a wise decision regarding the investment in inventory. There is a more risk holding inventory than any other item, because the inventory becomes obsolete, their quality may deteriorate. So if the consumer need, the consumer expectation changes, then the inventory may become obsolete, and the obsolete inventory is having only scrap value. Further, the inventory is having carrying cost and order cost that I explained in the introductory part. So that you have to keep in mind. So all the other activities, production activities, marketing activities, purchasing activities are largely depend on how you manage the inventory. If your inventory management is poor, all these departments function will be influenced. Now what are the objectives? Every company should ensure that they are having adequate inventory, not more, not less. And a smooth supply of inventory to the production department. Whenever the production department requires inventory, they have to supply. So the production activity should not be disturbed or interrupted. Now the inventory policy. Some companies may follow conservative inventory policy. Under the conservative inventory policy, company invests high amount in inventory. They purchase the inventory at bulk. So in conservative inventory policy, companies are focusing on maximum holding maximum inventory. On the other hand, in aggressive inventory policy, companies are not in the favor of investment, more investment in inventory. So they invest little amount in inventory, and whenever the inventory is required, they purchase it. Some companies may prefer the assembly activity instead of production activity. What they are doing? They are purchasing the semi-finished or say for example component from their vendors, and instead of manufacturing, they just assemble. So lot of policies are there in inventory management. Some companies are following aggressive inventory policy, where they are spending more amount on order cost and less amount on carrying cost. Follow the conservative inventory policy. Now, material control. Now, it is the responsibility of the company and their source department to manage the inventory by keeping in view all the necessary actions. Now, students, what are the objectives and advantages of material control? It avoids understocking and overstocking, as well as it keeps the moral check as well as the regulation on inventory consumption. So if any department requires the material, they have to give the note why they need the material. They have to send the material requisition note to the stores department. After analysis of the material requisition note, they will issue the material to their production department. So material control is necessary. If there is no control, material will be used as per the wish of the production department, that the material may be lost. No optimum utilization, it will increase the wastage and definitely it will increase the cost of the product. Ultimately, it will reduce the company's profit. So material control is very necessary to reduce the overall cost of the product as well as optimum utilization of the rare resources. Now, the yes, inventory policy we discussed, the material control we discussed, now stock limits. What is the meaning of stock limit? For the better material control, company need to maintain the stock limits. Say for example, I will explain in this graph and thereafter we will discuss about material stock levels formulas. Students, for example, this is the graph. This 2000, 4000, 6000, 8000, 10000. I think that these are the stock limits. Every company needs to fix their minimum level. Minimum. That means the inventory should not come below the minimum level. Say for example, 4000 units. This is the minimum level. Thereafter, they have to fix their maximum level. That means inventory should not go beyond that level. Say for example, here 10,000 is the maximum. So automatically 4,000 and 10,000, 14,000 divided by 2, that means 7,000. So here we will get the average. Means we can maintain the material around to the average level, 8,000, 9,000 or 7,000, 6,000. Now the reorder. Company has to fix when to place the new order. When material reaches to the average level or minimum level, when to place the order. Say for example, company may fix that if the material reaches at 6000 unit level, they have to place the new order. So we can see that this is the reorder. Average level are already analysis. Average level is nothing but maximum plus minimum divided. So to be concrete, in this case, the maximum level is 10,000, minimum level is 4,000. So 7,000 is nothing but what? The average level. And the danger level. Danger level means if in any case, if the material is order is not placed, or if material is not received, and if the inventory level reaches to that point, that means or finance professors, they expect that your quantitative economy or order quantity is same. There may be a difference. 90% we can say they are same. Normally the economy or order quantity is used as a pure order quantity. But 100% it is not correct. 90% we can say. So pure order quantity is the quantity which should be ordered when the stock reaches the reorder level. Then are the stock levels. Lead time. Lead time means the time required to get inventory. So it is a time or duration between the inventory order placed and inventory received. So for example, if I place order, after how many days the inventory reaches to our company or our warehouse, that is called the lead time. So for example, I place order today and after 6 days if I am getting the order, that means the inventory of the goods at my place, that is for 6 days is called as the lead time. It may be minimum and maximum. So for example, minimum 6 days, minimum 5 days, maximum 8 days. Minimum 5 days, maximum 8 days. Okay. Average means minimum plus maximum divided by 2. So for example, in our case is 6 and a half hours. Student, we will solve one problem on inventory level. The question is on. I will take question number 3. The following information is available in respect of material. The page number is 214, question number 3. Reorder quantity already given. If not given, how to compute that I will explain in the next lecture. Reorder period is 4 to 6 weeks. Students, 4 to 6 weeks. This is nothing but what lead time. So 4 weeks minimum and 6 weeks maximum. So aaj agar aap order lete ho 4 hafte mein milta hai minimum time mein aur zyada se zyada 6 hafte mein humko idea aata hai ki itna din ki zarurat hai. Maximum consumption is 400 units per week. Normal consumption, also called as average consumption, is 300 units and minimum consumption is 250. If normal or average is not given, we can calculate in very simple way. Maximum plus minimum divided by 2. Emergency reorder period is given 2 weeks. If for example, if we need the inventory in very short period, that is for the emergency period. Reorder level. Calculate reorder level. Reorder level, what is the formula? Maximum consumption into maximum reorder period, or minimum level plus average consumption into average reorder level. So we can use both the formulas. Another is minimum level. So we are having the minimum level formula. We are having maximum level formula. We are having the danger level formula. So reorder level is subsequent after calculation. We will take maximum consumption into maximum reorder period formula. Maximum consumption. Given in the problem that the maximum consumption is 400 units. 400 units. Okay? And the maximum reorder period, which is 6 weeks. So 400 into 6, nothing but 1,400. In our question, the reorder level is 400 into 6, that is 2,400. Next point is minimum level. What is the formula? Reorder level. Reorder level is 2,400. Minus average consumption. Now, average consumption strengths given in the problem, average consumption is normal consumption 300 into average reorder period. Students, average means normal reorder period, maximum 4, maximum 6, minimum 4, minimum 4, maximum 6. So average kitna? Between 4 and 6, that is 5. 5 weeks is nothing but what? Average reorder period. Very simple. 4 plus 6 divided by 2 will get the answer. So 300 into 5, that is called 1500. So 2500 minus 1500, so the answer is 900. So 900 units should be your minimum level. Next point. Maximum level. What should be the maximum level? Also called as the ceiling point, ceiling level. Iske aage nahi jana chahiye. So minimum reorder level. Reorder level is 2400 plus reorder quantity. per period is 4. So it will come 1000. 1500 minus 1000. So 500. So add term 2900. 2900 units is your maximum after this. Reorder level will be computed. Average level is very simple. Maximum, that is 2900, plus minimum, that is 900, becomes 3800 students. 3800 divided by 2, divided by 2. So it will become 1900 students. This is our average level. And thereafter, danger level. So, danger level. Minimum level is 900 units. We can say that 900 here. This is our minimum level. Maximum level 2900. Yeah, yeah. Yes, maximum. Reorder level 2400. Will come here. Reorder. Average. We have seen in previous lecture about the inventory management, and we discussed the importance of inventory management, objects of inventory management, and what are the various strategies adopted by the various companies regarding the inventory management. Normally, company maintains the stock level. Also, we discussed in previous lecture how to compute these levels: minimum level, maximum level, danger level, reorder level, reorder level. Level we discussed and computed and we presented in graphical manner also. Now in today's lecture, we are going to discuss the reorder quantity, also known as economical order quantity. If the stock level reaches at the reorder level, what should be the quantity to be required for placing an order? So therefore, economical order quantity, that formula is available with the finance manager. Now why this formula is to be used? But before discussing this formula, we should understand the two costs attached with inventory. Beside its actual cost, beside its original cost, there are other two costs attached with the inventory. One is order cost. Students, when a company places an order with its suppliers, definitely they have to do some research work, they have to take the tangibles, then they have to analyze the quotation, thereafter they have to place the order for the administration cost is required. They may do these works to the BPO or APO, they may charge some amount. Transportation cost, if you order 50 units or 100 units, the transportation cost will be same. For example, if I wishes to buy 2 kg potatoes from the market, and if I go to the market and bought 2 kg potatoes, and in another way if I again I went to the market and I bought 4 kg potatoes, the transportation cost on my that means the marketing cost is same. So before placing an order, the transportation cost need to consider by the business person. Inspection cost, when the goods is received in the factory premises of the company, they have to inspect the goods. They have to scrutinize the receipt of goods, whether the goods is in a proper condition or not, whether the goods is damaged or in a good condition, whether the goods is as per the order or not. And everything is analyzed in the phase of inspection. And the other one is the insurance on transportation. Thereafter, carrying cost. Besides the order cost, carrying cost, if you bought the goods, you have to store it. For that store department cost is the store staff salary. Then material handling cost, insurance cost for the stores department, storage rate, then all is known as what? The carrying cost. Now, there should be a proper trade-off. I will give you one example. For example, if the company's annual need is, say for example, 36,000 units. If they wishes to purchase all 36,000 units at a time, for example, on the first month of the financial year, in the month of April, if they are going to buy 36,000 units, what will happen? They have to place only one order, so it will reduce the order cost, but it will increase the carrying cost. Carrying cost will be increased. So, unnecessary stock pipe will be in the company, and that is not good for the any company. So, they have to order the goods which is necessary for the operating cycle. So, every business organization should understand their operating cycle. Operating cycle means time period required from the raw material conversion till the receivable collections. And already I have explained the working capital. So, here we have analyzed the operating cycle. The operating cycle is 3 months and the raw material storage requirement is 1 month, then they should order the inventory monthly or every 2 months. They can place the order. So, lot of things are there that is to be considered, but this formula will help us. What quantity should be placed for the order? So, students, I will explain in detail about this formula. Let us understand what is the formula and its what values we have to take. So, in scale 2, A means annual consumption. Company has to estimate their annual consumption in the upcoming year. Once they confirm with the annual consumption, we have to find out the order cost per. Basically, we can calculate order cost per order. So, if they wishes to place the order, what will be the order cost that they have to pay? Say, how that is what you entire order cost. And there are the carrying cost per unit per annum. So, for example, to store one unit every year, what storage cost is required? That they will tell you. You don't worry, you will get all the information in the problem. Just you have to keep this all the input, the information in the form, you will get answer. Now, we will go for one question. Page number 218, question number 7. From the following particulars, find out the economical order quantity. Annual demand 12,000 units, order cost 90 rupees per order, and inventory cost per unit per annum 50 rupees. Calculate economical order quantity. Very simple. 2 into A, annual consumption 12,000 units, and 90 rupees is your order cost, divided by 50. You have to multiply, thereafter divide by 15 and then up to scale nikalna. So you will get the value 380 units. 380 units means company need to place order around 380 to 400 units, in which they can make proper trade-off between order cost and carrying cost. So what is the problem? If you are going to place less order, carrying cost will be increased. And if you want to place more orders, what will happen? Carrying cost will decrease, but order cost will increase. There should be a proper trade-off, balance, dono mein balance hona chahiye. Nahi order par jyada hona chahiye, nahi carrying par jyada hona chahiye. So there should be a proper break-even or trade-off, and for that economical order quantity is very much helpful. Another question, we will go for question number 9, page number 219. Semi-annual consumption 6,000 units. One point we have to keep in mind, students, here, that we don't want semi-annual or monthly or weekly or quarterly consumption of water. We need annual. So if any information is there which is not in annual form, we have to convert it. Say for example, semi-annual is given, you have to multiply it 2, or if quarterly is given, you have to multiply it 4. So here 2 into semi-annual consumption is 6000, means annually 12000. 6 महीने का 6 है, तो 12 महीने का 12 है। And thereafter, order cost is given 45 rupees. Students, carrying cost is not given in rupees form, but what they have said, quarterly carrying cost is 3%. Again, what is the ceiling for carrying cost per unit per annum? Quarterly means 3 monthly 3%. Means 12 month, that is annually 12%. So carrying cost is 12%, but we need in rupees. And what they have said, the purchase cost of every input is 25 rupees. एक यूनिट का कॉस्ट 25 रुपए और साल भर में उसको स्टोर करने के लिए कितना खर्च होता है 12%. कैसे आया 3% क्वार्टरली 3 into 4 4 क्वार्टर्स आर देयर इन अ ईयर सो 3 into 4 कितना आएगा 12 सो 25 into 12% 3 rupees. So you solve this equation, you will get the answer 600. Again, we will go for question number 12, page number 220. The purchase manager of an organization has collected the following data for one of the A-class items. Interest of the lock-up capital 20%. Students, keep in mind, interest of the lock-up capital always comes under the carrying cost, interest cost. Yes, so it is a carrying cost. Okay. Order processing cost 100 rupees. This is order cost. Inspection cost, inspection comes under order cost. Follow up cost for each order, nothing but what administration for order cost, so it will come under the order cost. Bill fresh, obsolescence, all will come under carrying cost. Other holding cost, 15%. Other procurement cost, that is procurement is nothing but what order cost. Annual demand 1000 units and cost per item 10 rupees. What should be the economical order quantity? The students, here, O and C is given, but not in total. Various aspects are given, bifurcation is given. We have to make the total of all these figures, and thereafter we have to calculate the carrying cost and order cost. Now, all the information which is given in percentage form is nothing but what carrying cost, and all the information which is given in quantity form is order cost in this question. In this question, all the information which is given in the term of percentage, that is our carrying cost, and the information which is given in monetary terms is nothing but what our order cost. So I will calculate the inventory quantity very easily. First of all, we have to find out the total order cost. So order cost kitna hai? Yes, 100 rupees. Order place the order. Inspection of 50. Thereafter 80 rupees follow-up cost, 170 other procurement cost. So if you make the total 150, 230, 400 rupees. 400 is our order cost. Thereafter carrying cost. Yes, carrying cost. So carrying cost. Yes. 20% interest plus 5% bill fetch plus 15% other holding cost. So total 40%. Yes. Now our cost per item is 10 rupees. We need in rupees form. So 40 rupees ka 40%. Sorry, 10 rupees ka 40%. So it will come rupees 4. 4 per unit is our carrying cost. How do you compute total? We have made the total of the percentage carrying cost and applied with the actual cost of the unit, material unit. We got the carrying cost per unit per annum 4 rupees. 2 into annual consumption is 1000 into 400 is our order cost divided by 4. So 2 into 1000, 2000, you multiply with 400 and divide by 4, and thereafter you find out the square root. The value will come around 447. 447. Mean around approximately 450 units they have to place for the order. So different problems are there. You can solve it. I will go for next question, question number 17. Question number 17 I am going to read. Their company supplies plastic crockery to fast food restaurants in metropolitan city. One of its products is a special bowl, disposable after initial use, for serving soups to its customers. Bowls are sold in pack of 10 pieces at a price of Rs. 50 per pack. The demand for plastic bowl has been forecasted at a fairly steady rate of 40,000 packs every year. The company purchases the bowl direct from manufacturer at Rs. 40 per pack. The ordering and related cost is Rs. 8 per order, and the storage cost is 10% of the annual percentage per annum of an average inventory investment. Calculate economical order quantity, calculate number of orders made to every year, and calculate the total cost of ordering and storage of balls for the year. So first of all, we have to calculate the economical order quantity. Economical order quantity is 40,000. 2 into 40,000. Yes. Order cost required given in the problem is 8 rupees divided by carrying cost. Carrying cost 10%. But iska we don't want 10%. We want in one unit. So 40 rupees is cost into 10%. So if you solve this equation, you will get the answer. It comes 400 packs or 400 units. Okay. Now the annual need is 40,000 units. So number of orders. How many orders we have to place during the year? 40,000 divided by 400. Means total 100 orders we have to place. 100 orders we have to place. Agar humko 100 orders saal mein humko place karna hai. Now you have to find out the order cost and storage. Students, total order cost. Yes. How many orders we have to place? 100. And per order cost kitna hai? 8 rupees. Means order cost. Correct. Every order needs rupees 8, and 100 orders, so 108 to 8 is nothing but what? 8. Now next point is the carrying cost. Carrying cost. Yes. At a time, we will keep 400 units reaches. But 400 units may not remain during the, say for example, during the operating period or during the inventory holding period. Even the deteriorates, as soon as you purchase the units, at the beginning it becomes 400, but it comes down as soon as we started its procurement to our department. So maybe today it is 400, but maybe next day it may be 350, thereafter it may be 300, thereafter it comes to 200, then maybe it comes to 100, and further it comes down, and thereafter company again places the order. So that is the cycle of the inventory. So, therefore, for the accounting purpose, 400 units should not be taken, so average unit is to be taken. For example, in the beginning, 400 units and at the end, 0 units, means on an average, company is holding for half of the economical order quantity during the month. For example, in our example, 400 divided by 2. So, always keep in mind, calculate the carrying cost, we have to divide it to 400 or any quantity. And as we know that the carrying cost per unit per annum is 4 rupees. So 400 divided by 2 is 200. 200 into 4. table calculation of inventory management. Table calculation. Question number 22, page number 227. Question number 22, page number 227. A firm's inventory planning period is 1 year. Its inventory requirement for this period is 1600 units. Assume that it is order cost rupees 50 per order. The carrying costs are expected to be rupees 1 per unit per year for an item. The firm can procure inventories in various lots as follows: 1600 units, 800 units, 400 units, 200 units, and 100 units. Which of these order quantities is the economic order quantity? Use table method and use equation. Student, here we will not apply directly the formula method, that is the equation method. They have given different lots from minimum to maximum, and thereafter they asked us to calculate the overall cost. Afterwards, we have to check whether the inventories, means whatever classification is given according to the table method, is reconcilable with the equation method or not. So, what I will do first, I will here compute this inventory level with table method.
Equation 2
AO divided by C. Now 2, annual consumption 1600, order cost 50 rupees, carrying cost 1000. You can compute with this formula, the units will come 400. Okay? So it is nothing but further questions you have to solve. Now going for the another part, that is the ABC classification of the inventory. Students, a lot of theories are there for inventory management. One theory is ABC analysis. Another is the ABC analysis. Now, what is the meaning of ABC analysis? Here, the company analyzes all the goods with the value and quantity wise. It analyzes the A class of goods. A class of goods where the quantity is less but in value their volume is high. For example, company may need some very poor units or poor material for the assembly purpose and their cost may be very high. In quantity they may be less but their cost may be very high. So such type of key products are known as what? Class A goods. For example, this is quantity. Here it is value. A type of goods is present here in this form. Its quantity is less but value is A type of goods. Now next is B type of goods. B type of goods, here quantity in total material is normal, we can say that moderate, and their value is also moderate. So if you come around here, this will be the graph for the C type. And C type, quantity wise they are more, but value wise they are less. Now, company should focus more on A goods. There should be strict regulation regarding the A type of goods. Because there is a more chances of misuse, of material A goods. If any material A type of goods lost or became obsolete, then company has to suffer the misuse. B make moderate control criteria and C make list control, we can say that yes, general control or if the tip may be then the other which will come, but A should be properly managed. So it is helpful for the reduction of overall inventory management cost as well as it is beneficial to manage the inventory in a very limited time. Now another point is VD analysis, that is called vital, essential and desirable. So the company should classify their inventory in three categories, just like ABC. Vital, essential and desirable. And according to that, two focus should be there for vital goods, thereafter essential and thereafter yes, desirable goods. Now generally in lockdown period also, we have the preference size over all needs. Whatever goods are our grocery items, which are very much vital, essential for our daily livelihood, that we are buying first. All the relaxation goods, or just we can say that the goods which we have enjoyed, which was not necessary for our daily livelihood, say for example chocolates or dry foods, and we are not buying today. Our main focus is what? Purchase of grocery, grain or the pulses or cooking oil. These are very desirable, or we can say very essential. So just like the company should classify their goods into these three categories. SD analysis is also there, where the goods is classified into three categories dependent based on the concept of availability. Okay, so that is another part. That is nothing but what? The scarce, difficult and scarce, difficult and easy availability of the goods. Next point is calculation of the inventory turnover. Inventory turnover helps us to know whether the inventory is moving at fast level or at a slow level. If the inventory is circulating at a slow, that is not good for the company. It is harmful for the working capital management. So it is just indication that the inventory is properly moving or not during the operating cycle. So already we have saw the problems there on, but I will take one question there on. Question number 29, page number 233. From the following information, calculate stock turnover ratio. Gross sales given, sales return given, opening stock given, closing stock given, purchases given, and direct expenses given. Now, students, turnover ratio. Yes. Turnover ratio. Inventory turnover ratio is equal to cost of goods sold divided by average stock. The cost of goods sold means nothing but what? Sales less gross profit, or opening stock plus purchases plus any direct expenses less closing stock. So already they have given us in the problem, the opening stock they have given 70,000. So calculation of cost of goods sold, opening stock. Yes, 70,000. Purchases 3 lakh. Direct expenses 1 lakh. Less closing stock. Yes, 85. Okay, so it comes 3 lakh 85. It comes 3 lakh 85. Now average stock. Average stock means opening stock plus closing stock divided by average stock. Yes. So opening stock is 70,000, closing stock is 85. Divided by 2, it comes 77,500. 77,500. So we will calculate the inventory turnover ratio. Cost of goods sold 385,000. And yes, 77,500 average stock. So you will get the 4.97 times. Means approximately 5 times. So during the year or during the operating period, say for example, financial year, there inventory is moving at 5 times. The 5 times. Now sales information is given which is zero. So if number of times are high, means the inventory is moving at this proper speed. If it is a low, that means at the desirable speed. Another concept which is used in just in time, which is normally innovated in the Toyota company after the Second World War. To reduce the inventory cost, these companies are now using the just in time technique. But it is only possible where companies have optimum internal control system. Either internal control system strong edge, either inventory management strong edge. Why company is just-in-time technology uses it? With the help of SAP technology, SAP software that is available worldwide. This may be that normally the production is reduced in a company. They are placing more and more order to the vendor. And very key components are only manufactured in the company. Very key components, say for example the engine, or very core part of the engine is only manufactured in the brand company. And another components are order to the vendor. वो एक बार आने के बाद उनको टाइम दिया जाता है. दे आर मेकिंग वन एल्गोरिथम बिटवीन द मार्केटिंग प्रोडक्शन डिपार्टमेंट एंड प्रोक्योरमेंट डिपार्टमेंट दैट इज अ मटेरियल डिपार्टमेंट और अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट दे आर प्लेसिंग ऑर्डर टू द वेंडर्स. सो इट रिड्यूस द इन्वेंटरी कॉस्ट. मुझे अगर 5 दिन में 100 मोटर कार बनाने के हैं तो आज मैं उसका इन्वेंटरी प्लेस करूंगा, कल तक मुझे वो मिल जाएगा. सो इट रिड्यूसेस द इन्वेंटरी. So that is called the just-in-time. You may have done the JIT in MHRD.